45% to 44%. And in Virginia's 7th District, Democrat Abigail Spanberger is leading Democrat Dave Brat 46% to 45%.
Can we stop right there, Willie? I think this is one of the most fascinating races, because Dave Brat has run. Of course, you know Dave Brat, the Tea Party darling, that beat the majority leader at the time. But he's running one of the dumbest campaigns in modern American history, where he thinks if he just keeps talking about Nancy Pelosi and saying Nancy Pelosi, that he's somehow going to win. Nothing else is required. And we've seen, 10, 11, 12, 15 mentions of Nancy Pelosi in debates. And his Democratic opponent has come back really strongly with some great ad campaigns. And I just think in some of these races, whether it's Western Iowa or whether it's in Brat's district in Virginia, voters are saying, hey, we're not that stupid.
Yeah,
we're not going to be fooled by stupid campaigning.
Well, he's also, Steve Kornacki, bringing in Steve Bannon, apparently, to campaign for him here. His closing argument is the Steve Bannon argument, is the Trump argument, which is the anti-globalist, all the things we know Steve Bannon stands for. How does this play out on Tuesday?
I mean, clearly a play for the base there, and it's so interesting because that district, you're talking about the suburbs of Richmond, a big part of that district. You're talking about suburbs that have been changing politically, and you're talking about suburbs where Democrats are really investing in this idea of particularly women who traditionally maybe in some cases have voted Republican in the past around there being turned off by the Donald Trump version of the party. And if you've got Brat closing with Bannon, and don't forget the other factor in Virginia is the U.S. Senate race at the top of the ticket there. Right. You got Corey Stewart at the top of the ticket, who again Democrats think is going to offend those suburban voters. It's an interesting choice to close on there, just given the strength Democrats have been showing in the suburbs.
Well, let me just come back to the point that Joe was making, and that he referred to Steve Schmidt about Trump and being the center. Who's the